Now, we're going to attach the eyes. Now, I'm going to attach these eyes with a little glue. This is one of the things that I do a lot when I'm doing applique pieces with felt. I add a little glue to it to keep everything where it needs to go. I don't want things like suddenly whoop, falling out, especially if I have things that I want to line up in a very precise way. Now, you're probably thinking, how am I going to get these lined up? Well, first of all, you don't have to. If you wanted to do it this way, do it that way. Do your eyes that way. If you want to do it that way, do it that way. If you want your eyes to be larger than this circle, go ahead and find something that works for you. Just remember that the eyes, the portions of the inside of the eye, where did I put that? The pupil parts, of course I don't have them out here. There's lots of different sizes. And within this pattern for this particular doll, I am using a 13 millimeter black, this is the production of them, safety eye, and it's a flat safety eye. These are flat button eyes. That's what we're going to be using. Now, if you use a smaller one, because these are fairly large, you can get larger ones. I think that this one looks particularly nice with this eye. It gives what I call the right level of cuteness, because the bigger the pupil, the cuter the eye, especially when you're making like cute dolls and stuff. We won't talk about what it could actually, you know, if you put these teeny tiny little 9 millimeter ones in, they're not going to look nearly as cute. So if this part, if you want to make these, the whites, larger, then these are going to have to be larger. Does that make sense? And as you can see here, I order from Glass Eyes Online. I know it says Glass Eyes, but they have a lot of plastic. They're called safety eyes because they have a little tip things over here, a little piece that goes on the back. And when it goes to the fabric, this is like a little ratchet. It gets kind of a little nut that gets on there and it won't come out. These are especially good for kids' toys because you don't want little kids to be pulling on these and swallowing them. So, how do I find the middle? Now, I know that if I take my ruler out here, this is a little under 10 millimeters. It's like 9.9. So, it's about 10. So, I rarely use what are they called, friction pens, to mark where I'm doing things or putting embroidery or adding embellishments. Again, a big part of that is I don't have an iron, so I can't get rid of the marks. I could lay it out in the sun to get rid of the marks, but I don't want to risk anything fading. So what you saw me do there was I folded it in half. And I stuck a couple of pins in the fold here. So I have a rough estimate of where the middle is on this side. And I know that I want one of the eyes to go in the middle. So I need to figure out how I want to do this. Now, why am I putting three instead of two? Well, first of all, two is going to be getting into the territory of copyright infringement. If you know what I mean, you know what I mean. And second, I'm working with rule of three. This is a more balanced and, how would I say, pleasing arrangement rather than this. There's something wonky about this, wonky, or this. And even though I'm eschewing working with very precise cuts, like on a Cricut cutter, I want this to be balanced. So this would fall into the rule of threes. It's got a center point, plus I've got a triangular kind of composition that I can look at. And I'm looking very carefully at these edges here. Now, I come in about at least a centimeter from each edge, which means this one needs to move in a bit. And if that doesn't, because you can see here, she's on the flip. I think she's a little closer. Yeah, she's a little closer. She's more like 8 millimeters from the edge. And I say 8 millimeters when you're looking at this. I'm looking at the edge of the white. 8 because there's probably a millimeter that's sucked up in that hem. So then I'm going to revamp this and move it over a little bit. And where you place them. Okay, that looks good. I think I'm going to bring that one down a little bit. Okay, there we go. That's where I'm going to put them. Now, if at this stage you're going, I just don't like this right here, you can always make the eyes a little smaller. In comes this one that I cut a little earlier. And I'm thinking that I might want to make these a little smaller. So how do I alter that? Well, because I've already cut one out that's smaller, one of the things I can do is I can just put these two together and cut around it carefully. Now, instead of letting this slide, you can see I'm using my finger and my thumb to hold it together tightly. So let's get rid of that weird little hump there that bugs. And I think that might work a little bit better. I am of the Julia Child kind of thing. School of thought, if I'm going to mess something up, I'm going to mess it up on camera and teach you a lesson. Because frankly, it's never straightforward. Okay, here's a good example. Okay, when I cut this out, there's this weird, I don't know if you can see it. It's like a little feathery bit right there that's kind of hanging over the edge that I just don't like. And I come in and I nip it off. And again, this is my creative method. Okay, I think I like that better. Okay, I made them a little smaller. And that works better. Now, do I want them up higher or lower? I mean, I could move them up this way. You can still go rule of threes. If I added a fourth one, man, that glue just set. So I think what I'm going to do is, for purposes of this piece, where many of you may just want to be like, get on with it, lady. I just want to make this one. What I do, pick this up. I'm not going to put a ton of glue. You can see about how much glue I put on there. I always glue the center first because the center should be in the right place. And then I can, this is in effort. If I started over here, I could potentially make them diagonal accidentally. And then I'm going to check over here and we're just about 8. Okay. And the thing is, don't have a heart attack if you mess this up. This is not the be-all, end-all. And you might be asking yourself, why don't you just pin these down? Well, I could, but remember, felt moves. Drink! And there's the potential for the felt to get pulled or stretched out of whack. Now, I don't know that I even wait for this to dry before I start adding in the stitch work to hold this down, which is what I'm going to show you in the next video.